Okay, and hello there. Basically just a one-off video. Well, may do a couple more. I'm thinking about it and might continue doing these, like something versus something, two arch rivals. But my first one of these is the Xbox One versus the PS4, the two new consoles coming out. So there's been much debate about these two, but keep the Xbox 360 bit there. So I'm just gonna compare them to the Xbox One to the PlayStation 4, and we're also adding the Xbox 360 to see if that can get any points, but I very much doubt it will. So first off, we're gonna do the controllers. So we're gonna ignore this and we're just gonna look at just this side. So if we just quickly get to see this bit in a minute, but yeah, we've got the controllers. So on an honest opinion, taking in everything, even though I'm a PlayStation person, got to give credit to the Xbox. Their controller does look pretty nice, but yeah, the grip seems better and overall it just seems looks nicer. It's like more of a rounded shape instead of this. The PS4's added some good features, like the pad, the little touchpad thing, and the built-in speaker thing. So what we're going to do is we're just going to judge these, and I'm just going to judge them, so whichever wins gets 1 point and everything, so I'm just going to put that away. And 1 point to the Xbox. So now we're going to go just through each line, and we can see which wins. But we're gonna cross some of the Xbox 360s out of one. We're only gonna do it on certain ones because there's no point comparing it to the other two. So yeah, we're just gonna do the PS4, and we're gonna, for the first CPU cores and the threads, we're gonna do all three. So yep, we've got 3 out of 6 in the Xbox One, so not very good. No, Xbox 360, sorry. And then 8 out of 8 in the Xbox One, 8 out of 8 in the PS4. So that will put another point onto there, and 1 point onto there. Next we've got the CPU frequency, which we are just going to judge the Xbox One and PS4 through, because the Xbox 360's got no chance, quite frankly. But the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4 are exactly the same on 1.6 GHz, so that'll be 1 point each. Again, we're just going to judge this one just out of PS4 and the Xbox One. So I'm going to keep speaking, but I'm going to keep getting rid of these at the same time. So yeah, we've got the the CPU UArch thing. There we go. CPU UArch thing. I don't really know much about this, but yeah, Xbox One and PlayStation 4 have both got the same thing, so we're just going to give both of them an upset. At this moment, we've currently got the Xbox on 4 points. And we've got the PS4 on 3 points. And we're going to do it like this from now on. We're not going to put the little lines in because that takes a while. So next we've got the shared L2 hatch. Sorry if I said that wrong, but I like to say it like that. So on the Xbox 360, it's just got the 1 megabyte one. So just a single one. But on the PS4 and the Xbox One, it's got two megabyte ones, so that'll be 5 points to 4 points because they're both the same again. And now onto the GPU cores. The PlayStation 4 absolutely like thrashes the Xbox on this one, I suppose you could say. It's nearing double the Xbox One, so PlayStation and Xbox gonna get the point to make the scores even on 5-5. Now we go onto the peak shader throughput, and again the PlayStation 4 beats the Xbox One. I don't know much about that, sorry. I don't know much about like the system memory, as I'll explain that in a minute. So the embedded memory, PS4 doesn't do this. So the Xbox One gets the point. So just a little explanation on that. Basically, it's the memory inside the thing. So like, not the total memory, but like it has more memory due to being the Xbox One. So yeah, the Xbox has 32 megabytes of memory embedded, plus the system memory, which we'll find out in a minute. Again, next, the embedded memory bandwidth. Xbox 360, 32 gigabytes per second, and the Xbox One, 102 gigabytes per second, and the PS4 doesn't have a single one. Well, doesn't have embedded memory, so it can't have embedded memory bandwidth, so we're just giving the Xbox One the point there. Now we go on to system memory. Now, I thought this was kind of a main factor, so I researched this quite a bit. And basically, the Xbox 360 has the GDDR3, and the PS4 has the GDDR5. So the PS4 has the, not new version, but the newer version of the Xbox 360 system memory, which has nearly, 16 times the amount of megabytes, and four times the amount of MHz. But comparing the Xbox One to PlayStation 4, I read quite a bit about them, and most people preferred the GDDR5 to the DDR3. And when I looked at the key factors, I just thought overall the GDDR5 is much better, so we're going to give PlayStation that point. Next, we're going to have the system memory bus. Basically the bits thing. So, again, Xbox 360 completely out the window, 128. The Xbox One and the PS4 have the same of 256 bits. So we're going to give both of them the point now, as we just have. So, with two things remaining, it's currently 8 all. So, the system memory bandwidth, quite clear result there. Xbox 360, as always, is very low. It's the 360. Xbox One should be better theoretically. But yeah, but that only got 22.4, so not bad, but not obviously better than these two. But then the PS4 got nearly triple the amount Xbox One does. So therefore, the PS4 wins that. So it's all down to this last little manufacturing process. Not going to count the Xbox 360 in this. And they both have the same of the NMs, so we're going to put that to 9, and we're going to put this to 10. So if you're looking to buy stuff through specs and stuff like that, like which has better memory, overall I would recommend the PS4. The credit to the Xbox One, it still looks very, very, very good. But yeah, so now we're just gonna do sorry about this, just thought it'd be fun. My personal opinion, as I said earlier, I'm a PlayStation person, prefer PlayStation. So yeah, I would go for the PlayStation 4. There was much talk about the Xbox One not being able to share games, and if you've not seen the video, it was quite funny. I'd check it out if I was you. But now the Xbox have changed that, so you can share games. Kind of suspected. I thought they would have to do something when that was released. But overall, PlayStation 4, better memory, which better everything, and the controller, even though I did say the Xbox One controller is nicer, which it is, has more specs. So overall, I'd go for the PS4, and the specs would go for the PS4. So thanks for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it will like make you think about what you buy.